In this video, I'm going to show you step by step exactly how to clean your email list so you can prevent your emails from landing in the spam box. Let's get into the content. All right, so the first thing we're going to talk about is the importance of cleaning your list. Now, when it comes to, you know, generating leads, you know, trying to get more customers for your business, the thing about that is you're either going to be using paid ads or you're going to be using organic traffic, right? Now, the thing about that is when you use organic, you're using your time. When you use paid ads, you're using your money. And either way you go, you want that to pay off, right? So when you have a clean email list, it makes it very, very simple for you to be able to do that because you're going to have higher conversions because you actually have real people on your email list, right? And this is so, so important because I remember back in, you know, I want to say about 2015, I had a lot of people that was being, you know, put on the email list that I had. And the way that I was doing that was I was actually using solo ads. And I'm going to just be straight up with you. Solo ads is not something that I really enjoy, which is why I tapped into the traffic that was already there. And then I went the YouTube route because people are already searching anyway, right? I realized that, yes, I was spending a lot of money on solo ads and it wasn't really paying off for me because first off, those people don't know me. The second thing is I was, you know, reaching out to people to let me put my offer on their traffic, which I don't even know where that traffic came from. So what I did was I actually used a tracking tool, which I still use today. And I sent that link to the solo ad vendor to make sure that those clicks that I was getting was real because I was noticing that the people weren't clicking on the stuff. And then I was having a lot of bounce emails and all this other stuff. And at that time, I didn't really know what was going on. I was just frustrated because I was like, man, like I'm spending this money, but these people aren't even opening the emails. And so that's when I ended up making a shift to more organic and I started doing a little bit of paid stuff, but more of my own paid stuff. So I really know what's going on. All right. So let me actually show you exactly what you need to do. Okay. So this is actually one of my softwares that I use to actually put my leads in, right? So this particular list has 1,136 people. And so what I could do is I could literally just hit export all contacts and then boom, it's going to automatically download it. But after you've done that, the next thing you want to do is make sure you have a software that actually allows you to automate the process. Because yes, you can do it manually. You can go through and spend a lot of your time, but time is the most important thing that we have that we don't get back, right? So as an entrepreneur, we have to be making sure we're not wasting that. Now, if you want to learn exactly how I automate the process and what tool I use, then I'm about to show you how to use it. And if you see value with it, you can definitely use the first link down below in the description. That'll allow you to get access to it. Let's get to it. All right. So what we want to do after you went ahead and you downloaded your CSV from your CRM, you want to go ahead into the software once you get access to it. And let me just kind of break a few things down in the software so you have a little bit of knowledge on it. All right. So when you come in, it's going to bring you to this page, which is the upload your file page, right? This is where you're going to upload your CSV. The next thing is you can go to the download your results page. I'm going to show you what that looked like here in a minute. And then the single email validator. Now, the thing about this is going back to valuing your time, right? Do you actually want to sit there and do every email individually? I don't think you want to do that. And I don't want to do that either, right? And so I always upload the file. And then another thing I'll show you real quick, I'm going to go to the integration. So if you have AWeber, Constant Contact, MailChimp, HubSpot, Shopify, any one of these right here, then you can actually integrate it with this software. So as soon as your list is being built, those emails are coming in and it's automatically verifying them, right? And that's a lot of power in that, right? So that way you don't actually have to come in here very, very consistently, of course, unless of course you just want to. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back to upload your file. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna upload the file that we actually just downloaded, right? So you go ahead and click right here. All right, and then it's gonna ask you to, you know, upload the CSV. So yeah, let's go with this one right here. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit validate file. Now, before you do that, you got two options. You can either go with the monthly plan that they have, or you can go with the on-the-go credits. Now, me personally, I always go with the credits because then I could just use what I want for what I need. All right, so then I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna hit validate file. All right, so as you can see, it has emails only because that's the only thing that I actually collected, right? And that's very, very important for you to understand. Now, if you are collecting first names, you wanna make sure that you specify it over here in this column. And then down here it asks, is row one a header row? For me, it is, right? And what does that mean? So over here, you see how it says first name, email, phone, right? If your stuff actually says that, then yes, for me, it would be row one is a header row. So then I would go ahead and I would hit process file. And then what it's going to do is it's about to start the process of actually going through the emails and verifying if these emails are valid. Are they spam abuse? or spam traps, abuse, and all of those different things. So this was the last results that I had, right? So I uploaded 743 emails, and then you can see 719 are valid emails, right? So what does that tell me? Over here, you can see I have one invalid over here, which I shouldn't be emailing that person because that's not a real email. And I'm gonna show you the status codes here in a minute. And then we got catch-all. So on this list, I had a catch-all. I had three of them, 16 abuse emails. And then we got four on the do not email list, right? So that's, they're clearly telling me, do not email the people on this list, or it's gonna hurt your sender reputation score. This stuff is so, so powerful. And this is literally how you're able to get into your people's emails, because that's what you wanna do in the first place, right? You don't wanna be wasting your time spending money on paid ads, or, you know, using your time, you know, creating videos or whatever it is that you're doing, and it's not benefiting you. What you wanna do is, once you get this data, you then wanna download your email list. And I'm gonna show you exactly what it looks when you looks like when you download your email list. So let me move me back down real quick so you can see exactly how this looks. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go right here to documents, or I might just wanna go to the desktop, I think that's where it's at. All right, so right here, let me actually show you real quick. All right, so I'm gonna go to this email list, I'm gonna expand this out so you can see exactly what's going on, and then I'm gonna go right here to where it says YouTube ranking playbook process, because I wanna show you what they do for you once you actually download the results. Okay, so as you can see, it says YouTube ranking playbook abuse. So all of the emails that are on that list that were considered abuse emails, they're literally going to put them and, you know, categorize everything to where it makes it easy for you to just upload the list that is valid. So right here it says all results. I don't want all results. I don't want to email the catch-alls. I don't want to email the people that's on the do not mail list. I definitely don't want to email the invalid emails, which are essentially fake emails that people put in, right? This is why for me, I constantly scrub my list, right? I go usually about every 2 weeks I scrub my list, but I would never go a month without scrubbing my list, right? And I highly recommend that you find a schedule that works best for you. And then right here, they even give you like a spreadsheet overview of what's going on your email list. So check this out, top domains. So we can see we got a lot of Gmail people, Yahoo, Hotmail, and so on and so on. And we even got, you know, domains, and it tells us 14 domains. And then it also tells us validation results. So we got 109 emails that are valid versus all these people that are not, right? So that's eight emails that I wouldn't email, you know, don't matter what nobody tell me. I'm not emailing those people, right? Because I only want the people who are valid on my list. So let me go ahead and close this out real quick. And then they show you the spam traps. I definitely don't want to email those people. And then the unknown. The only people that I want to email is the valid people. So let me actually show you the status codes real quick. All right, so right here it says status codes. We're going to go ahead and click on that. And then as you can see, it tells us valid are, these are emails that are determined to be valid and safe to email to. They will have a very low bounce rate, which we don't want bounce rates. We want to actually show up in their email inbox, right? And then right here, invalid. These are emails that are determined to be invalid. Please delete them from your email list. Think about how powerful this is. You get this information without having to manually do it yourself with like re-engagement campaigns, because when you really think about it, when you do a re-engagement campaign, you're still sending out to the people that are on your list, which is doing what? Hurting your sender reputation score. And if you're not familiar with what that is like a credit score, but for your sender reputation. And the more and more you send out the invalid, spam trap, abuse, and all of that stuff, it's not benefiting you. And every time you email, eventually, it's going to go to the spam box every single time. And you might be watching this video and you might be like so frustrated already, because that's probably happening to you. And you're like, man, why is nobody opening my emails? Why is nobody buying? Or why is, you know, I'm pretty sure you're frustrated at this point, all right? And then once this is done, all you're going to do is you're going to click on this, and then it's going to go ahead and allow you to download it to your computer. All right, and then it's gonna ask you the things that you want, right? So you can see right here, select the columns you want to be appended to your results. So for me, I just let everything go through, and then I hit download file, and then boom, it's gonna pop up the little thing for you to download. And then, okay, it's taking a little longer than I wanted it to take right now. Okay, so there it is right there. You save your email list, and it's gonna be aligned exactly how I just showed you to where they structure everything out. So now that you know how to clean your email list, I want you to watch this video next, because it's gonna teach you some email deliverability strategies you could use right now if you really wanna avoid that spam box. See you over there.